Hey, math class. Okay, so we have looked at changing fractions to decimals, and we've actually looked at changing decimal numbers to fractions as well. I just want to review both of those two things just a little bit. So remember, if I want to change this decimal to a fraction, all I'm going to do is write that 625 over how many places behind the decimal point this is. Okay, so here's the tenths, the hundredths, and the thousandths. So because it's the thousandths place, I'm going to put 1,000 under here. Okay, that's all it is. 625 thousandths becomes 625 thousandths, right? They mean the same thing. And then once I have this, I have to check and see if I can reduce it at all, which I can. I'm going to start by reducing them both by 5, okay? 625 divided by 5 is 125. 1,000 divided by 5 is 200. These two numbers, let me write them again down here. They can be reduced by 5 again, right? 125 divided by 5 is 25, and 200 divided by 5 is 40. Oh my gosh, I can divide another 5 out of these guys. 25 divided by 5 is 5, 40 divided by 5 is 8, and so after all of that, I can see that 0.625, or 625 thousandths, equals 5 eighths. Okay. So again, this is just a review of what we've already done. Let's review the other kind of problem that we have done. Okay, if I have 3/4 and I want to change this fraction to a decimal, all I have to do is divide my bottom number into the top number. And since I can't do that because the 3 is smaller, I'm going to add a decimal point and a 0 and go 4 into 30. Now, I know 4 can go into 30. It's going to go 7 times, which is 28. I have 2 left over. I don't feel like I'm done yet, so I'm going to add another 0, drop it down. Can 4 go into 20? Yes, it can. It goes 5 times. And I'm done. So up here, I can say that 3/4 equals 75 hundredths. Let's look at just two more quick examples of both of those again, just to make sure that you're going to be like really, really good at remembering what the answers to everything is. So here I have 1,220. This is the tenths, hundredths, thousandths, ten thousandths place, right? So 1,220 ten thousandths, okay? So all I do again is go like that. Right? 1,220, these are commas, that's a comma, this is a comma, as opposed to a decimal point. 1,220 ten thousandths. And again, I gotta reduce this guy down. Okay, I can start with a zero rule, right? And just cross those zeros out. That'll leave me with 122 over 1,000. These are both even numbers, right? I'm going to divide a 2 out of both of them. Let me write my answer down over here. 122 divided by 2. I don't know that one off the top of my head, so let me do some figuring up here. Da, da, da. 2, 1, 61. Okay, I know 1,000, where'd my number go? 1,000 divided by 2 is going to be 500. And I don't think anything else can divide out of these guys because 61 is prime. So I'm going to come back over here and say that 1,220 ten thousandths equals 61 over 500. Let's look at one last example here. This one I want to change this fraction into a decimal point, okay? So I know I have to divide my bottom number into my top number, okay? And I can't do that, so I gotta add a decimal point and a 0. Can 2 go into 10, though? It can't, so I have to add a 0, so then I'll add another 0 here. Because really what I just did is that, right? Can 12 go into 100? Yes, it can. 8 times, which is 96. I have 4 left over. I'm going to add another 0, drop it down. 12 into 40 goes 3. Minus 36, I have 4. Oh, do you see what's going to be happening here? It's just going to be 8, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, forever. So I can come over here and say that my answer to 1/12, if I want to convert that to a decimal, my answer is going to be 0.0833 repeating, or 833/10,000ths, however you want to say that. So we'll be practicing sort of changing back and forth between fractions and decimals in our next class period.